Ooh, everybody. This is my AuthorTube newbie tag. AuthorTube newbie tag was invented by Jenna Streety, and I have my laptop here to read the questions of the newbie tag. AuthorTube, I'm very new to this, okay? It seems to be a YouTube community where authors speak about their writing life, give tips and advices and writing advice or publishing advice. Yeah, and so because I'm an author now and I make YouTube videos, I'm part of AuthorTube. So let's get started with the newbie tag. How did you find out about AuthorTube? I watched a video of Jenna Moresi, something like this, and she spoke about what communities supported her, and AuthorTube and BookTube was mentioned. And this was the first time I heard of BookTube as well. So I started making YouTube videos in BookTube and in AuthorTube before I even know that it existed. But yeah, now I know and I think it's awesome. What genres do you write in? Currently I'm writing Lit RPG. And generally, I write sci-fi, fantasy, and cultivation novels. I haven't wrote a cultivation novel yet, but I have one in my mind. What is your preferred writing tense, point of view, and category of story? I like reading third person point of view and first person and second person as well. I haven't wrote a second person point of view yet, but I read a really good fan fiction. I believe it was Harry Potter fan fiction in second person. I liked it a lot. Writing tense, past. I wrote a book in present tense in German because I had problems with the past tense in German. It didn't sound to me right. So in English the past tense sounds to me right, and I prefer writing and reading in past tense. I think my German book in the present was something I just had to get out of my system. Sometimes you have to do things you know that aren't great, but you have to do them to move on. And this was this kind of thing. So now I can move on. But now I have another thing in my system, and that is a horrible slow pacing. And I'm really struggling with my pacing at the moment. I'm at chapter 17 in my story, and nothing happened. Nothing but a bank robbery, and that got resolved in one chapter. So yes, but I have to get it out of my system and write slowly, slowly, slowly. And I think then in the future I can cut it down and make 10 chapters in one chapter, and it will be a good story. A category of story. Why didn't they make 3 questions? It's 11 question overall, and I don't see why they have to do three questions in one question. I mean, it would be totally all right if it would be 13 bullet points. Okay, not for the superstitious, but for me it would be all right if it would be 13 questions. Never mind. Category of story. Not YA. I read so much YA when I was a young adult that I don't need it anymore. Question number four. Are you a plotter, panster, or planster? I'm in my mind plotter and writing panster, so that would make me a planster. Number five. Are you self-published, published, or yet to be published? I'm web published. Number six. What publishing company, literary agent, and or printing company are you represented by or use? If you are not yet published, what is your dream publishing house and or literary agent? I'm a web fiction author, so this doesn't apply to me. I might indie publish my web fiction when it's on a more complete state, like when some plot is there. Maybe I don't wait for the plot to come to my story, that would take too long. But I publish my story on four platforms at the moment. That's Wattpad, Webnovel, Royal Roads, and Fiction Press. If you want to check it out, don't choose Fiction Press. I think I will discontinue Fiction Press soon. What AuthorTube-related videos can we expect to find on your channel? Videos related to web fiction. I already made a video, what is web fiction? And I made writing life videos, mostly in the vlog form, writing schedule videos, how I plan my writing day. I don't think you will get any writing advice from me soon, because I'm a very inexpensive. Yes, I'm inexpensive as well, but inexperienced writer. No advice. A video I plan soon is about my spreadsheet. Lit RPG authors are very dependent on their spreadsheets and stats, and my spreadsheet is a monster, and I like to share my little monster spreadsheet with the world. I think that are more the kind of videos I'm gonna to make, like share my experience, share my growth as an author, not as advice, but as, okay, that's one way to do it, like to share my way to do things, to tackle the writing life or career or whatever. Next. What was the first story you ever wrote? I don't know. I won't count stories for school. I tell you about the first story I published in the internet, and that was Severus Snape Smut. No, I don't tell you about this story. Next. What authors have inspired your writing the most? J.K. Rowling is one of them, because I loved how spare she is with description. I strongly dislike descriptions. I never finished Lord of the Rings. I laughed not knowing the eye colors of Ron and Hermione. She was the first author who satisfied some of my pet peeves. A huge pet peeve of mine are what I call dick touches. That are women who are just in the story that the man can dancing and romancing. The male protagonists can dance and romance with them. I loved it that Hermione was no dick target for Harry. So she's really one of the first. The hero gets the girl. No, the hero doesn't get the girl. The girl is perfectly fine with getting someone else. And this was a really huge, huge, huge relief for me. Well done, J.K. Rowling. And she done it again and again and again. And yeah, I really admire this. And I'm very heavily influenced by the Chinese web fiction writers. They are very spare on descriptions as well. They are spare on inner monologue as well, what I really admire but can't do for myself. I'm very heavy on inner monologuing. But it might be something for the future, because they perfected the show and not tell, or let's say the protagonist never tells how awesome he is, but everyone around him, oh yeah, he's so great, and all the face slapping, and yes, I like Chinese web novels. Next. Do you schedule your writing sessions or simply get to writing whenever you can find the time? I schedule them and that works very well for me at the moment. From 10 to 12 o'clock in the night. So at the moment I'm making this video in my writing time, but I'm not a stickler for the rules, but I use them as general guidelines, and that works very well for me. Do you write on a computer typewriter, write everything out by hand, or use a blend of those? And where do you write in general? I write in my kitchen, and I write on a laptop. Yeah, and this question is a bit old-timey. I believe it would be more interesting with what kind of softwares do I use. So I just added, I use Grammarly, and I use OpenOffice, OpenCalc, the spreadsheet thing from OpenOffice. What are you most looking forward to now that you are part of AuthorTube? Views? Yeah, maybe I should something say like, oh, this awesome community, but I looked at the AuthorTube community after I did know that they existed, and it was just spill the tea here, drama there, and egos over all the place. And I thought, I found videos I really enjoyed, and writing advice which I profited from, and that's great, and it's a hope of mine that people can profit from my experience as well. So maybe this is one point. What was the question? What are you most looking forward to now that you're part of AuthorTube? I mean, if I say I look forward that people profit from my experience, I mean, I don't know if they profit or not. I hope they profit from it, but looking forward to is, I think, the wrong expression. Use? All right. That was my newbie tag. So I hope you enjoyed getting to know me a little bit and my writing endeavors. Please like and subscribe and do this YouTube chess. And I'm very proud of myself that I remembered saying this, because usually I forget. Bye-bye.